Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech DIY. So this time we are going to see how to ingest data in our application. Data ingestion means the English meaning of data ingestion is taking data from flat file or some kind of text file or CSVs and ingest or make use of that and put that into our application, so our application can make use of that and produce whatever it is intended to do. This is our launchpad. So again, we are going to use Gradle project for this session, and the project name, as you can see on the screen, and we are taking Spring Batch as the dependency, one of the dependency, and with that the other dependency we are going to have is HSQLDB, because it's a small sample project, so we are not going to create a relational DB in our machine. Instead we are going to use in-memory relational database, RDBMS. So for this session we are following Spring IOs, getting started with Spring Batch. That session, that link will be provided in the description section of this video. And so that's pretty much of it. And we will walk through this site section by section when we are doing that particular section. So and we are using Java 8 and packaging would be jar, and with this let's import project in Gradle, I mean in IDEA. So project import is happening. I already shown how to import project in IDEA, so you may refer previous videos. And now the project is meanwhile the project is loading. We can see, so this kind of CSV they are suggesting, this is a CSV file, like where they have names like name and first name, last name in the CSV, and that they are doing through batch jobs. Okay, so batch jobs works mainly in industrial scenario. Batch jobs works for data ingestion. One scenario is data ingestion, wherein loads and loads of data we want to ingest into our databases or data warehouses or any kind of data storage. So we want to do that, this is the way. Okay, so now in the left side, in the right side, you can see now it is loaded. So our CSV is source.csv. that CSV we are importing here, that's there in the desktop. So we are making a copying that here and naming it as source CSV. We are pasting it here so that we can read it from class path. So under resources folder we have pasted it. So this is the content of that source CSV. Just for this sample we have also put only few records you can consider. Otherwise in real life scenarios you may see like hundreds of thousands of and more than that records in one spreadsheet or one CSV file. Okay, so now let's see the build Gradle, what is there or what is extra added by Spring. So as you can see, we are having Spring Batch test. Spring Batch also startup batch is also added, and that's the Gradle part. And as you can see in the left side, so basically let's take a pause and consider the case. So our spreadsheet, what we will do is we will consider our spreadsheet as a single model, okay, input model. So this is our input model. And in this case, this particular case, we are having input and output both as it is we are putting in the database. But if you want to process or if you want to change some data type and all, So we can have two separate models. One is input model and one is output model, that we can do like that also. But in this case, we are going to have single model. So that is person model. And here we, as I have shown you earlier also, so in source CSV, we have three things: first name, last name and skills. So that we are going to have there. We are thinking to, instead of, you know, doing this by getter setters, I am thinking to make use of Lombok here. So definitely we will add Lombok in the dependencies, and because that way code would be more readable and boilerplate code would be removed from here. But before that, we are just trying to, you know, do as it is shown in the link, reference link. So we have added two strings, we have added getter setters here. We will show to add Lombok again, and that time we will, you know, remove the boilerplate code. So we have created our model object. Again, I am repeating myself, if we are doing date processing or any such processing wherein the data type types of the attributes are different, in those cases we need to have two separate input and output models. But in this scenario, since we don't have that kind of situation, so we are simply reading from the input file and putting it that into the database. So we are going to use the same model, we are not processing in between, so we can do like this. And now we need to write the item processor. Basically this item processor implements item processor. We are writing our own item person item processor. So item processor interface, that provides one abstract method, that is process method. So we need to override the abstract process method. And so as I said earlier, instead of writing the boilerplate code, why don't we use Lombok? So we are going to add the Lombok dependency here. So we are going to add compile section, because Lombok works on compilation. So end compilation and while doing our processing, our editing part. So that's where, once we put the proper annotation and all before compilation, it, you know, converts everything into the bytecode, into the proper bytecode, generates that bytecode and then work on that. So that's how Lombok also work, Project Lombok works. So now we have added SLF4j so that we can straight away use the logger provided by SLF4j annotation. Okay, so that's it. So what here, a simple code, I mean anybody can understand this code. We are simply reading all the fields and putting them in the in these constants, string constants, and then we are putting them into this person object, transformed person object, and that object we will be, and this whole operation we are doing under the process function, process methods, process abstract. We are defining the process method, which is the one level higher abstraction, or we can say like parents method. So we are overriding it. This kind of programming is called hook based, wherein we are providing the definition to the hook, and the framework will take care of doing all the surrounding things. Okay, so that's what we have done here, and this process is basically actually transforming our input person object and returning output object. So this person object, which you can see public person, that person object is again our transformed person object. Okay, so the output is transformed person. So each item we are it would be iterating, and it would be putting that into this transformed person one by one, and it will be processing that. So that is what this process item processor will do, as in the link also it is showing. So what it says, person implements Spring Batch item processor interface, input and output types are not need not be same. So same thing they are also telling whatever I have explained just now. So let's go there and see what's wrong here. Okay so we are going to add annotations, Lombok annotations now. So if you remember earlier also we have covered in previous tutorials or previous playground sessions, so in Lombok if you put add data, so it takes care of injecting getter setters. All constructor, as its name suggests, all are constructor, no are constructor, they are they are injecting those kind of constructors there in our model class. And now we need to, item processor we have written, now we need to we need to define the batch job. So batch job is we can have a scheduler or we can run it once. Okay, so in this scenario we are just running once, but we need to define the job, the like what job this has to work on. So this that's what is explained here. So now we are going to write batch config configuration class. So this configuration class would be basically it would be the you can say like the whole and soul of this this batch configuration. So it says like the building blocks, connecting pieces, we are actually connecting the dots here. We are going to have job builder factory, we are going to have step builder factory, and those things are put together in this, or we, as I said earlier, connecting the dots here. So the focus on this area or focus here. So first things first, we need to enable the batch processing. We need to add the annotation saying enable batch processing, so Spring Boot will enable batch processing into our API, and that's how auto configuration works. So now we are auto wiring through constructor this time, not directly on the properties, instead instead we are doing constructor based. So this kind of auto wiring is called constructor based, where in our constructor we are passing the job builder factory and step builder factory. Okay, now we need to add the beans which are provided by Spring Batch in order to make use of them or injecting them in our in our container, Spring container. So we need to have a flat file item reader. As its name suggests, this is an item reader, so it will read the read our context model, that is person. So it will read the person object one by one. Okay, and it just reads them. Okay, and here we are saying it naming it as person item reader. And resource, here in this resource we need to tell like what resource. So path of class path resource, since we are having the source.csv there, so that that path we need to give here. If we are using from file system, then we need to give a file system related class here. Okay, so that we have given delimited. Since we are using CSV, so by default the delimiter would be comma. So CSV means comma separated file. So CSV means that. So it is by default taking that delimiter with parameter, and names, in names we are just passing the column names. What column names we are going to have there, that we are passing here. Further field set mapper. Okay, so field set mapper again, bean wrappers field set mapper we are going to use here. And in this we are going to say target type, because target type is our again here target type means the the model which we are going to use for putting into the database. So we are going to use person, again same class we are going to use. So if we are having different model for output, then that class we need to put there in the set target type. Okay, and now we need to add the process item inject the process item as a bean. So that also we are doing here, and then we need to have the JDBC item writer. So what we are doing is we are reading from a flat file and we are putting into the item writer. Through via item writer we are actually putting into the database. So again, as I said earlier, since we are using for this tutorial we are using HSQLDB, which is an in-memory database. So in case if you are using some other relational databases, those data source configurations you need to do in your application YAML or application.properties file. Okay, and that also you can see it's quite easy, so that you can do that from our previous videos. And here the JDBC batch item writer, what it is doing, let's see. So we are going to use bean property item SQL parameter source provider, and under this in left side, as we can see what they are saying. So we need to do the insertion here, the insert into our table. So our table's name is people, and under that table we are going to put this data from this Excel sheet. So that's what we are doing. So field names we need to give, and if you know the basics of SQL, you would have encountered this particular statement many a times. You know, this insert statement is used to, you know, inject or insert data into the table. So that statement we need to write here. Okay, so that is what we are doing here. And then we are going to tell Spring that okay, this is the data source. So let's code it. So by data source we are guiding Spring that okay boss, this table is available under this particular database, and you know, and store it in the way we are suggesting from here. Okay, so that's what we are doing here. And since it is a builder, JDBC item writer builder, so if you are familiar with builder pattern, so builder pattern also works in the same way. At the end of the, you know, if you want to implement, if you want to actually invoke the method, you need to call the dot build method, then only all of the above statements will work. Otherwise it's kind of lazy processing, wherein until unless we will say dot build, it will just store the things. I mean something similar to our streams, Java 8 streams, wherein terminal operation is there. So until unless it encounters terminal operation, it won't actually process. So something similar like that works in builder also. So that is one thing. And now we have given delimited, we have given names, we have given item reader, sample CSV, yes we have added that. Person object, we are also using person object. Processors, person item processor, writer also we are using item writer, yes we are making use of that. We have injected our process item person item processor, yes we have done that also. Item writer we have added. Enable batch processing we have already added. SQL statement needed to insert, yes we have done that. In single person driven by Java bean properties, yes that also we have done. The last chunk from batch configuration.java. So this last chunk also we this last chunk we need to add actually. So what we are saying here, we are having here import user job, and we are passing the listener, job completion notification listener, and step. Okay, so this configuration we need to do, and this job completion notification listener we need to add it separately. I mean, we need to customize it. I will show you that also. Until we define this job completion notification listener, we are going in the editor will go the or the IDE will show this this red mark or error mark. So please bear with me, it will be resolved in some time later in the same video. So we are going to have job, we are going to import user. So what it meanwhile what it is saying, the first method defines the job and the second method defines the steps, the single step. Jobs are built from steps where each step can involve a reader, a processor and a writer. In this job definition you need a parameter, you need an incrementer, because jobs use a database to maintain execution state. You then list each step. Through this job has only one step. The job ends and the Java API produces a perfectly configured job. Okay, so it is telling about the job configuration. So these two steps, whatever we are doing currently, import user job and the second one is this step configuration. So these two are needed for our job configuration. Okay, so that is what we are doing here. We can incorporate or we can add any kind of scheduler here, and we can tell the system to read the CSV file from some particular folder and in a fixed interval and load that data into database. So that also we can do with Spring Batch, but in this simple example we are not doing that. But yes, definitely it is possible here by injecting or by using any kind of scheduler. Okay, so as I read that in left side, it is we are adding the incrementer, listener, flow, step one and build. All that we are doing again, we are here also we are using builder, factory build, factory. So yeah, so we have done that job builder and getting the job builder from factory, and then like that we have almost done the import user job part. And let's create the okay, we need to annotate all these beans. We need to annotate with add bean so that our Spring container will identify them or inject them. So now we are going to write the step, simply saying step one. So that is what we are doing here. So in step we are telling, okay, input first is input and second is output model, as I said earlier also, dot reader. So reader would be reading from this reader method. As you can see in our batch configuration itself, we have defined this reader method, we have defined the processor method, writer also we have defined above. And and let's create the job completion listener class now. So let's write job completion notification listener. Basically job completion notification listener will be invoked when the, as its name suggests, right, I mean at the end of the life cycle, when actually the job is completed, what we need, what we are going to do. So that we can define here in this particular method, and this will be actually using job execution listener support. It's again an abstract class or a parent class. So we need to extend job execution listener support class, okay, and then that class we need to and the child class we need to define here, and we will be using JDBC template here for this sample. So same way, let's create a constructor for this. So in this constructor we are going to inject define our JDBC template, and we are doing auto wired. This is something as per industry, or this should be the followed or best practice. We should always do the auto wiring through constructor instead of setters. That's considered as one of the best practice. So, and now we need to override the method of after job. So as its name suggests, after jobs means once the job is finished, what we need to do. So there can be several scenarios. Once the job is done, we just want to read the data from the database, whatever is inserted just now. We just want to see that on the console. So here we are logging that data in the console. So we are just adding the log information, and that's what we are writing. Job finished, time to verify the result. So JDBC template dot query, in queries we are writing simple select query, select first name, last name. These are the fields we have defined under the in our while creating the schema. So again we are having DDL statements in our project itself. So when our project will start, it will drop the table and it will create the table again. So in case if we or in the real life scenario, we should be using a database, a proper database, in which case we would not be dropping again like this. So for sample only we have used this kind of database. So now select query is run, and after that it will return the result set and raw. We are iterating over each raw in this lambda function and we will put that in the log. So we are putting that, we are in our new person object, we are going to put all the three parameters, all the three fields, first name, last name, and third is skill sets. So that is what we are doing, and then iterating over all the result sets which we have just now read and put into the persons object, and then iterating over each one of them, and then doing the logging thing, doing the logging part here. So yeah, so I think you should be able to see the code here. Job completion. So basically, as I already said, batch status, again batch status is a class which gives the different statuses batch job can have. So batch job status is completed, we are checking that is completed, and then only we are doing the JDBC template dot query. So that is done. Now for this example or for this sample, we are also going to modify our main method so that we can run with Gradle run, Gradle boot run command, or we can run from command line runner. So so any which way you want, we are going to use Gradle run command here. And we need to define, we need to, under system.exit, we need to to copy paste our the run method, spring application dot run. That's pretty much whatever is written on the left side. We are doing the same here on the right side as well. What error it's showing, we need to see. Okay, exit, spring application run. Now it is resolved, so this should work fine. Okay, now it seems like our code is fine, and we will try to build it, try to run the Gradle boot run. Let's see in the left if we miss something. We have modified the Spring Boot application, enable auto configuration. Okay, it's reading about the Spring Boot application annotation. So as most of you might be knowing, that Spring Boot application is composed of add configuration, at enable auto configuration, and at component scan. All those things should be fine. And now run Gradle boot run. So Gradle boot run is the command we have modified our main with that. So as you can see in the right side, the file which was behind is was the DDL file, I mean DDL.sql. Oh, so there is some issue. Okay, so what it's saying, okay, person log.info, it is not able to identify the person objects, and what the issue could be. Although it's not showing any error while in the IDE, but while running it's showing that kind of error. So let's see how can we resolve that error. It's saying for each person dot log dot info, so found this person object, it is saying not able to identify. What can be done, we'll see. JDBC template, okay, this should be fine. Let's see, first name, last name, skills we have given, so that also should be fine. And while reading here, we also have given the same names. It is skills, so we are going to define it here as well. So it's matching. It's matching everywhere now. Skills. Let's rerun. But the error is still there. Item.getFirstName is still not able to identify the getter setters. At this point of time, I was very much, I was looking at it very seriously. I was not able to identify what the issue is. Then I suddenly thought of using or checking the Lombok configuration. So with my previous projects which I have done earlier. So we need to do this also, annotation processor also. So compile only and annotation processor. Okay. So so we need to do that while doing the packaging. I mean the build.xml or the gradle.build should have that configuration instead of just simply compile. And the second issue now which we are getting is the bean injection. So our spring container is not able to identify the bean, step bean. Okay, so while configuring we forgot to add add bean annotation for step 1 method. So now we have added that, and now yippee, we are able to do that. Now as you can see, we are able to do that, and it is showing the data, exact data also. And one more thing is, we can remove the first line of our source file, because that is showing the names of the column. That is not needed in these scenarios, because we are defining the table column names also. Okay, so we can remove the first name, last name and skills, and directly give that. And yeah, this was the source dot CSV which we are opening in numbers application. So it is importing that into numbers, and it will show. Okay, so we have used some very famous name like Jonathan Ive. He is a design expert in Apple. Steve Jobs, visionary. Bill Gates, CS. Elon Musk, our times visionary of current time, Elon Musk, he is also here. So here ends another exciting playground session on Tech DIY, and thanks for watching, and please provide your feedback in comment section, and share these videos with your friends, your colleagues, and the people who are actually doing things on this and actually stuck with such kind of issues, so they may get help from this. And apart from that, please do like, share, subscribe, and subscribe more. And until next session, next exciting session, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep learning, keep enjoying, and be positive in your life, not corona positive. Okay, enjoy life. Bye.